Hi, hold on a sec. I'm just making sure everyone can see the broadcast here. Just make sure everything's working. Just give me a second here, sorry. Just making sure I'm showing up on the YouTube Live page. Okay, we're set. I want to welcome everyone. This is a live shoulder workout. It's a 60-minute workout, and it's appropriate for all ability levels, beginner through advanced. Don't worry, you beginners, I won't lose you. You advanced people, I'll make sure you're sore. All you're going to need for this workout is a set of dumbbells and a chair. First, a quick reminder. Tomorrow at the same time, we're going to have a live arm workout, so please join me for that also. We're going to go ahead, we're going to do 10 minutes of warm-up, 50 minutes of lifting weights, and then at the end, I'm going to do a 15-minute Q&A session. Now, I'll also answer questions between sets when I can, when I'm not explaining stuff to you. First, can I get people to post comments on the YouTube video and let me know if you can hear the audio okay? We've had some trouble with this in the past, so please go ahead and let me know if you can hear me. Okay, while you're doing that, let's go ahead and get ready for our workout. Let's see here. We're gonna do some warm-up sets here. Okay, warm-up sets. The shoulder is a really small muscle. You can seriously injure yourself if you use too much weight or you don't warm up. And I'm going to make sure you don't have either of those problems. So we're going to start with some dumbbell press. And we're going to use about a quarter of the weight you usually do. So just go ahead and get started there. Put about a quarter of the weight you normally use and warm up. Just do some... It's funny how this feels really heavy. Just not warmed up yet. Now, some key pointers on form here. I only go down till my arms are horizontal and then back up. That's one point. Another is I'm sitting in a chair here, but I'm not leaning against the back. I'm sitting on the edge of it. We'll explain why later. That's really important. Now we're going to do a set of side raises to warm up. If you don't feel like adjusting the weight on your dumbbell, you can just put your thumb through a dumbbell plate and do side raises. When we do these, again, we're not leaning against the back of the chair, just sitting up, shoulders back, down and back. So just do some nice warm-ups here. Okay, we're gonna continue the warm-ups, but I'm gonna cover some more important points on the form of the dumbbell press here. So we cover, you sit on the edge of the chair, you don't lean back. We only go down this far. The most important thing is your shoulder position. This is gonna apply for every exercise in this workout. I'm doing a video on this next week, but it's called packing the shoulders. You always hear me say, keep your shoulders down and back, down and back, down and back. Well, in this upcoming video, I'm gonna tell you why that's so important. But let's talk about what that means. So, shoulders up, down, forward, back. So, you want your shoulders down and back, and you hold them like that. Chest thrust out through the whole exercise. So, if you're doing side raises, you keep them down and back, like that. If you're doing press, you keep them down and back. What a lot of people do is they have wandering shoulders. So in the side raise, watch my shoulder and my ear. A lot of people do this. They bring, can see it better this way. A lot of people bring their shoulders up to their ears to keep them down and back. Okay, let's do another warm-up set. It's amazing how this feels really heavy until I warm up. Okay, and a set of side raises. Again, remember, keep your shoulders down and back. And let's, now, I know a lot of you who are sitting on your sofas drinking beers instead of joining along with me are going to see me doing these shoulder press and say, well, I can do 10 times that weight. Let's talk about that. It doesn't matter how much you do. All that matters is you use good form and it's taxing for you. Let's cover why I say you sit on the edge of the chair. So this is how most people do them. They sit on a something with a back. They don't realize it, but they're leaning back about like this. And then a lot of times they slouch when they're doing it too. So they do their shoulder press like this. Now, this is not shoulder press. You can probably do 3 times the weight if you're doing them this way. It's because this is an incline press for pecs. The pecs are a far bigger and stronger muscle than the shoulders. The more you lean forward, the more you're working pecs and the less you're working shoulders. If you sit on the edge of your chair, it's all shoulders. So that's what we're gonna do. I don't care if you can only do a third what you normally can. That's what we're gonna do. Okay, last warm-up set. Then we get to the big business. Okay, and one more set of side raises to warm up. Oh, we are missing something, aren't we? Good comment. Someone said Hans needs to be in the picture. Okay. There's Hans. Okay. Now that we're warmed up, let's do our first exercise. We're going to do press. And you beginners, choose a weight that you can do maybe 15 to 20 reps. It's going to be a light weight because when you're not leaning against the back, it's really hard to do this. You might only be using 10 pounds. You intermediates and advanced, try to aim for, you know, 4 to 7 reps. We're gonna do heavyweight light rep. No. Heavyweight low rep. Just checking the comments quick here. I promise I will get to your comments between sets when I have a chance, but at the beginning, I have to tell you what's going on here. Okay. Now, all you intermediates and advanced know how to do this, but to get the weights up, you put them on your knees and you kick it up. That's the easiest way to do it. So kick them up. There we go. 2 minutes rest. The last weekend's workouts, we did 3 minutes rest. This time, 2 minutes. I just mix it up, as you know. Okay, I actually have time for a few questions before we get to our next set. So let me take a peek here. Okay, I'm looking for a question. Okay, great question. Someone asked, why no water during the workout? Very good question. It's because by the time you start working out, it's way too late. You have to be completely hydrated before you start your workout, like an hour before, or you run the risk of having a 19% loss of strength. Check my website about hydration and bodybuilding. Between when I woke up and this workout, I probably drank a gallon and a half of water. There's no way you can drink a gallon and a half of water during your workout because you're breathing hard, there's not time, and besides, you need to be hydrated before so you're really strong on your first set. It doesn't do good to start hydrating at the beginning of your workout because then it takes, you know, a couple hours to get hydrated. So that's why I don't drink during the workout. It's too late. I might take a sip or two just to be comfortable, but, you know, start 2-3 hours before. I actually recommend 4 hours, but, you know, I slept in. Okay, I'm sorry. Let's see. Sorry, no time for another question. We're going to do another set here. Wish I noted which YouTube user asked that hydration question. Excellent, thank you. By the way, there's a lot of questions going there on YouTube. I'm only answering good questions relating to fitness and exercise. No one wants to know about my dog, Milo. That one more time before we move on to our next exercise. Let me answer some more questions here. Let's see. Oh, scrolling by too fast. Well, let me get a question here. What is my arm measurement? That's not important. Let's talk about this workout. My arm measurement is proportional with my body. Okay. Let's talk about the speed. There was a good question there. About 2 seconds up and down. You're right, I was not using 2 seconds up and down. That's what I tell people when I'm first explaining to them how fast they should be going. It's because people go about 3 times faster than they think they're going. So if you tell them to go 2 seconds up and down, they go about this fast. So I try to keep it somewhere between 1 and 2 seconds. The main thing is that you're not going fast. A lot of people do this, and that's gonna get you injured. The slower you go, the harder it is to use bad form, which is why I prefer to do like 2 seconds for telling people. Another important thing, you notice I just saw a YouTube question. Someone asked, can I do these standing? No, I don't like that. The reason is when people stand, here's what they do. I don't know if you can see all of me. When people stand, they do this, they go, and they do all quads. Oops, sorry about that. The advantage of doing them seated is that you can't cheat like that. When you're seated, it's all shoulders. There should be no motion other than your arms. So that's why I don't like them standing. Okay, let's do our last set. And we're gonna do side raises next. But let me cover it again. So what we're going to do on the side raises, we're going to sit on the edge of the chair. We're not leaning against the back. Our shoulders are going to be down and back with our chest thrust out. And we're going to do this. I would recommend doing them thumbs up. That's the way I like doing them. It's easier on your elbow. Just as good for your shoulder. Okay, get your weights ready. Again, you beginners, aim for a weight that lets you do, say, 12 to 20 reps. You intermediates and advanced, let's go for 4 to 7 reps. This is a really small muscle you're working. Don't expect to do 50 pounds here. On a good day, I can do 35. Today, I'll probably do 25 or 30. Don't use a lot of weight. This is how you get injured. Use a weight that you can control with good form. Okay, I have time for one question here. How much strength do your hats give you? Well, I'm afraid to take my hat off and find out. Okay, we have 30 seconds before we start our side raises. Let me go ahead and let's get started. Okay, I'm already dripping sweat here. Okay, remember, shoulders down and back, thumbs up. Maybe this is too much weight. Oh, yeah. Time out. I don't want to start with 35. That'd be really funny, me injuring myself on live broadcast. Why this is actually good on a narrow chair, or better yet, on a footstool. I have this narrow footstool that would work better, but then I wouldn't be in the camera frame. Let's take some questions here while we're waiting 2 minutes for our next set. Okay, a number of good questions there. First, how normal is it for your shoulders to hurt? It is not normal at all. Shoulder pain is never good. Joint pain in general is never good. It's okay to have muscle pain, in your pecs after the workout, or in your shoulders to feel comfortably sore the next day. But if your shoulder joints hurt when you're doing this, something is very wrong. You either need to stop completely or find a way to do it that it doesn't hurt. A lot of times changing your grip can make a difference and let you do it pain-free, or you know, half the time, all people have to do to stop the shoulder pain is keep their shoulders down and back when they're doing the exercise, and they can do it pain-free. But there's no such thing as good shoulder joint pain. If you've got it, consider doing shoulder rehab exercises. We're actually going to do a few of those at the end of this workout. Let's see, what was the other question? What weight am I doing? This is actually 30-pound dumbbells is what I'm doing here. Good shoulder days, bad shoulder days, but what matters is that you use a weight that you can use good form. This was a bit heavy for me. I'm gonna do it again only because I don't have time to change the weight lighter because I was gabbing too much. I'll drop after this. Okay, side raises again. Remember, shoulders down and back. Don't lean against the back of the chair. Thumbs up. Okay. I'm gonna drop in weight. What you see a lot of people do in these side raises, again, what they'll do is they'll go really fast and use shoulder motion. So they'll go, and kind of throw them up. That doesn't do anything for your shoulders. Keep your whole torso stationary and just move your arms. You'll notice, I know a lot of you have commented that I wasn't going all the way up. Yes, that's correct. It's because I was using too much weight. It's better when you have too much weight to just continue the set, do the range that you can safely do at a nice controlled speed, and then correct the weight down at the next set. So now I'm dropping these down to 25 pounds each. Okay, we have one more set of these side raises. And let's see, what are we doing after that? Let me answer some questions. take a look here. Okay, for those of you that don't know, we did a live back workout last weekend. How's my back? I actually had DOMS for 3 days, so I had a great back workout, but I'm completely back to normal now. And a lot of people are asking about the rest time and asking, you know, 2 minutes, isn't that too long? Well, last weekend, I did 3 minutes. When you're lifting in the 4 to 7 rep range, personally, I need 2 to 3 minutes to recuperate before I can do another set. If I were to do another set after 60 seconds, I would really have to drop in weight. Later in this workout, we're going to do a little less time between sets and a little lighter weight. But at the beginning, I like starting off big weights with lots of rest. You gotta vary it. I try to vary my rest time, sets, and weights every week. But you beginners and intermediates don't have to vary it that often. The more advanced you are, the more often you have to change your workout up. Okay, let's do our last set of side raises. Okay, got a good sweat up here. Now let's talk about what we're gonna do next. we're going to do something similar. This time we're going to do a superset, though. We're going to do a front press and a side raise with the elbows bent. Let's see. One thing you'll notice, the weight that you use on these side raises, because of leverage, is very light. When you're doing them with the arms bent, you can do significantly more weight. So you're going to have to go ahead and bump up the weight on the dumbbells that you were doing. Now, if you only have one set of handles, you're going to need to swap the weights back and forth. That's fine. Just do it as fast as you can. What I found, I get all my weights at garage sales. Excuse me. Every time I buy another set of weights, it comes with a set of handles. So I have a whole bucket of spin lock handles. So go ahead and get your weight set up for the side raise. I think I'm going to do 35s. Now, these side raises with elbows bent, at gyms, almost everyone does these standing. And you know why they do it standing? Because you can do twice the weight when you're standing. Because people use that little bounce thing I was demoing before. People will do this. It's like, or I can't even demonstrate the bad part. But you can do twice the weight when you're doing that. When you're seated, it's all shoulders, and that's what we want it to be. There's no point, work your quads on your leg day. Don't do quads on your shoulder day. Let's see, now for the front raise, let me get that weight set up. The front raise is harder than it looks. So, actually I'm gonna use the same weight. I think I'm set. So, let's start off here with the front raise. Let me show you how we're going to do it. Elbows at your side, and then go up like this. Again, not leaning against the back of the chair. Shoulders down and back, same thing. So we're going to do a set of front raises, and then a set of side raises. Again, beginners, aim for 12 to 20 reps. You intermediates and advanced, let's go for 4 to 7 reps. Okay, starting with the front raise. Okay, now the side raise. I haven't done these in a while. Oh, I can tell, that's too heavy. So ideally you wouldn't have any rest here because this is a superset, but the price of working out at home, you have to fumble with the weights a bit. Okay, sideways. Shoulders down and back. We only get, we're doing 1 minute rest between these. So 1 minute, I have time for a quick question, then we'll go back and do that superset again. Okay, let me answer some questions here. Man, only 3 reps. Yeah, we're starting off with as heavy weight as we can with low reps. Okay, here's a good question from Puppeteers. I don't have a pillow, so I can't do a good old-fashioned pillow screen here. But the question was, what about toning exercises? There's no such thing as a toning exercise, okay? Toning is meaningless. There's two things you can do in bodybuilding. You can... I will answer that question later. We've had our 1 minute rest. So we're gonna do our front raise followed by the side raise. Okay, now our side raise, shoulders down and back. Okay, we get another minute rest. Okay, back to the question from YouTube. Toning exercise. There is no such thing. You can do two things in bodybuilding. You can get stronger and gain muscle mass, and you do that through resistance training, lifting weights. You can reduce your body fat and get ripped. You do that through a caloric deficit, either eating fewer calories or doing more cardio. There's no such thing as toning or a toning workout. What most people mean by toning is seeing the definition in the muscles. All that is reducing body fat. There's no special exercise. Doing a bunch of reps does not tone you. If you want to tone your abs, you're better off going jogging for an hour than doing an hour of ab exercise. Okay, that's our minute. Let's do our next set. I am dripping sweat. Again, a lot of you are probably saying, look at those teeny weights he's doing. It's not about how much weight you do. We're using good form, pushing our limits. If you want to use a lot of weight and cheat, you can do that, but you're going to get injured. I've been lifting 30 years and never had an injury in the weight room. I've been injured many other places in sports, but never in the weight room. So, here we go, front raise. Side raise, another rest. Shoulders down and back. One minute rest. Let me answer another question from YouTube. Okay. Okay, here's a great comment from the art DWP2. He says, Tiny, I'm 14 and I lift 10s. Again, it does not matter how much weight you're lifting. The shoulders are a really small muscle group. You're supposed to be lifting small weights. If you want to use big weights, do a chest workout. But you gotta do your shoulders and you can't injure them. If you do too much weight trying to lift as much as you think you should be able to lift, you're gonna get injured. So, you know, if you're doing these with 2 pound dumbbells, so be it. Just try to get a little stronger every week. That's what it's all about, getting stronger. And if you get stronger, the muscle mass will follow. Don't worry about it. It can take years before you see any development in your shoulder. It does take a long time. Okay. Front raise. Side raise. Shoulders down and back. Okay. okay, are we going to do that again? No, we're going to move on to the next exercise. Okay, let me describe what we're going to do next. We've already done the dumbbell press. We're going to do a fun variation. I love this. This is an alternating dumbbell press. We're going to do one side, the other side. So you better drop in weight significantly from the weight you were using when we first started this. Because this is a tough one. Because the side that's not moving, you have to hold. And that takes a lot out of you. Let's see. Get your weight set up. I am using about 60% of the weight that I started at. I'm doing 35s for this. Okay, so this is going to be, again, this is another superset. I like doing supersets because it's very time efficient for working out. So we're going to do an alternating press, and then we're going to do reverse flies. And let me show you how we're going to do the reverse flies. We're going to use our chair again. What I like doing, I bend over 90 degrees and put my head against the chair. I'm not leaning on it. All I'm doing is touching it so that I can feel and make sure that my head is not going up and down. Because we want our torso to be perfectly motionless when we do this. So we're going to do thumbs pointing toward each other, shoulders down and back, like this. Now, if you find that you have to go up and down, you're using too much weight. If you find you have to do this with your shoulders, notice this is bad form. Shoulders are, I'm letting them relax, and then I'm bringing them up. We want to keep them down and back the whole time. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. So, alternating shoulder press. Again, same deal. You beginners, keep it high rep, 12 to 20. Intermediates, advanced, we're not doing heavy weight here. So we're going to up our reps. Try to aim for 8-ish. We've done our low rep stuff at the beginning of the workout. Okay, no leaning against the back again. Okay. Okay, now let's do our reverse flies. Hope I don't have too much weight here. Okay, remember, bend over and just touch your head to the chair. Keep your shoulders down and back, and then up. Okay, I am using too much weight. I'll show you why in a minute. I love the feel of this exercise. Let me start the timer. These reverse flies are a really important exercise. They work the back of your shoulder, and a lot of people have this postural problem from just doing bench press and chest all the time. Their chest gets so strong that it kind of draws their shoulders forward, and they walk around like this with their knuckles dragging on the ground. Doing these reverse flies is great to help counteract the strong chest and give you better posture. So if you have not done reverse flies before, shame on you. You got to do them. They're really important. Next time I'll answer a question from YouTube. We have 10 seconds before we do our next set here. Remember, at the end of workout, we're going to do a 15-minute Q&A, so stick around for that, too. Okay, let's do the alternating shoulder press. Okay, now the reverse flies. Head lightly against the chair. Thumbs toward each other, shoulders down and back. Oh, I love the feel of that. Minutes rest. We're going to do that again. I'll answer a question here in the meantime. Someone said the camera stopped working about 40 seconds. It's been working here, so it might be your local data connection. Question for someone, how much can I bench press? Good question, I have a video about that, watch it. I had fun doing that one. Someone said zzz, like sleeping. Well, they're obviously not doing this workout. Okay, here's a good question. Is it good to wear gloves? I will answer that after we do our next set. Because time is up. Okay. Again, a superset. Alternating shoulder press. And then reverse fly. Keep your shoulders down and back. Watching this instead of following along, shame on you. Next time, get out your weights and work out with us. Okay, reverse flies, touch the chair, shoulders down and back. I'm sorry, I forgot the question I was going to answer. See if I can find it. Okay, you people who did shoulders yesterday are forgiven. You don't have to work out with me. Question about how old I am. Yes, I'm well over 50. Let's see, we're going to do one more of these, because I know you're getting tired of them, and then we're going to move on to our next exercise, which you will like even less. We're going to do shrugs with most people like, and then we're going to do innies and outies. People don't do these because you'll never see any muscle gain from innies and outies. However, they are what's going to keep your rotator cuff strong so that you don't get injured and you can continue to do the exercises you like doing, like the press. So, next one is shrugs and innies and outies. You'll need a towel for the innies and outies, so be looking for a towel around that you can use. Okay, let's do our last set, and then we'll get to the fun stuff. Okay, alternating press. You notice this is a very high volume workout. We're doing a lot of sets. Reverse fly. Okay, now let's talk about shrugs. You can do them on a chair. It's a little difficult because the weights clang against the side of it. And if you don't care about ruining your chair, it's okay. But better is if you use a footstool or something a bit narrower. What am I gonna use? Guess I'm gonna use the footstool. Now that's not quite high enough for me. So I'm going to raise it up with some... You'll notice all my plates are different because I get them at garage sales. These are the silly rubber-edged ones. Okay, now, shrugs. Most of you do shrugs, at least you intermediates advance. I'm going to show them how I want you to do them, because very few people do them this way. I'll demonstrate from the side. We're going to keep, again, you know you're getting tired of hearing this, shoulders down and back. This is how we're going to do the shrugs. And we're going to just go up and down from here, trying to keep the elbows straight. What a lot of people do is, you know, this motion. That's hard on the shoulder. We're just keeping the shoulders down and back, like this. You're not going to be able to do nearly as much weight when you do them this way. That's okay. Don't worry about that. Let's see. Actually, I need this higher because I don't have enough range of motion here. I don't have my encyclopedias. Oh boy, who am I gonna sit on? You Germans will enjoy this. I am going to sit on Duden. Okay, so let's do our first set of shrugs, and then I'll show you what we're gonna do with the innies and outies. So, shoulders down and back. Okay. Innies and outies. We're going to use a light weight for these. This is a very weak muscle that we're working. So we're going to choose very light. You can seriously injure your shoulder by doing too much weight on these innies and outies. You only need one dumbbell for this, so don't bother setting up two. What is that? I want to start out light here. Okay, now I'm going to clean all my stuff out of the way. Where's the maid? Wish I had one. Okay, let's start with the outies. These are outer rotations. Fold up your towel, do a little wad, and we're going to put that under our elbow. And so our elbow stays fixed against our side, and we're doing this motion. We're not going up here, we're stopping it horizontal. So that's too much weight. Because I should be able to go up higher than that. So that's the. And now we're going to switch over to the other side and do the outie on the other side. Okay, I'm setting a bad example for you. You should keep this well above the 10 rep range. Because if you're doing low reps like that, you're risking injury. Let's go to the innie. The innie is an inner rotation, which means you're rotating your arm toward the middle of your body. You can typically do more weight with that one. We're not going to use a towel for this. Get on your side, put your hand over your head to get it out of the way here, and rotate in. Again, keep your shoulders down and back. Again, this helps strengthen your rotator cuff muscles so that you can continue to do your chest workouts and heavy shoulder workouts pain-free. This is the cheapest insurance policy you're ever going to have, is doing these innies and outies. Okay, we're actually not going to use any rest in this superset, because it's already been 2 minutes since we've done our shrugs, so we're going to go right back into the shrugs here. Again, I just wanted to show my German viewers there for amusement what I'm using to sit on. Okay, shrugs. Remember, shoulders down and back. Elbows straight. Don't turn it into a curl. You see a lot of people using ridiculous weights on these. And a lot of times they're standing and they jump and use their calves and quads and Lord knows what else. Everything except their traps when they're doing the shrugs. Okay, now we're going back to outies. Since I'm good from learning from my mistakes, I'm dropping in weight so I can get a proper rep range here. Okay, towel under our elbow. That's a better weight. Shoulder down and back. Again. Don't expect ever to see any bulging muscles from this exercise, because you won't. That doesn't make it any less important. Okay, then most of you, when we go to the innies, the inner rotations, you're going to have to add weight. I do, because I'm much stronger on the inner rotations, okay? So now reset your weight. Minutes away from being done with this workout. Remember though, I'm doing a 15-minute Q&A at the end of this workout, so I hope you join me for that. Okay, again, shoulders down and back. We're going to do one more round of this, one more set of shrugs. One more set of innie and outie, and then that's it. Is it just me, or does the image look kind of distorted? I need to figure that out. It looks like the aspect ratio is wrong. And I know, I'm sorry, I'm deafening you every time I drop the weights. Okay. Inner rotations on the other side. Okay, one last round. See if I can keep us on schedule here. We're supposed to end at, on the hour. Okay, shrugs, shoulders down and back. I don't know about you, but I'm drenched. Okay, more innies and outies. Okay, you know what? I don't want to reset the weight. I'm going to do the innies first because a weight's set for that. Save some time. So we're going to do the inner rotations. Again, your elbow is pinned at your side. Don't let it wander. Shoulders down and back, as always. Again, my video next week is going to explain why it is so important in chest, shoulder, and lat exercises to keep your shoulders in that down and back position. You know, I've been saying that for years and never explained to you why, so that's what I'll be covering this week. That's my shocking secret. Okay, drop the weight and do the outer rotations. Okay, this is our last set. Towel under our elbow. Again, I wanted to thank you very much for joining me for this live workout. And again, tomorrow at the same start time, we're going to do a live arm workout. So please join me for that. Again, at the when I'm done with this set, we'll do a 15-minute Q&A. And I'm not sure if and when I'm going to do live workouts again, so please join me tomorrow. It may be your last chance. when I do these live workouts, I don't have time to record my normal weekly workout. So I need to get back to doing my normal weekly recorded videos for YouTube. I only have so much time on weekends and after work to do this stuff, and the live workouts take up all my time on the weekend. Okay, that's it. Now let's do some Q&A here. I'm going to be answering questions both on Facebook and on YouTube. So, let me start, bring up two windows here. Let's start with Facebook. I've been ignoring them. Okay. Okay. Matt on Facebook asked about gloves when doing the alternating shoulder press. Here's what I feel about gloves in general. I don't use them. The only time I use anything on my hands is when I'm doing lats, because my wrists give out before my wrists give out before my lats do. And I want to focus on lats. I honestly don't think that gloves prevent calluses at all. If you lift weights, you get calluses. It's a fact of life. You just deal with it. The one time I would use gloves is when you're doing really heavy weights, heavy dumbbells, a lot of times you can get a serious pain in your wrist here. In that case, gloves can help a lot. But what I recommend in that case is a simple $3 pair of leather garden gloves. The thick leather that's stiff is actually excellent for distributing the weight over your palm. It's, in my opinion, far better than the expensive lifting gloves. Typically, the cheaper the glove, the harder and stiffer the leather. So a cheap pair is perfect. Okay, let's go over and answer a question from YouTube here. Okay, what do you feel is the most, this is from Rocock 100. What do you feel is the most important shoulder exercise that you must do to gain mass in the shoulders? You know me, I disagree with everyone. Most people think it's the pressing exercises like this. You know, I actually favor the side raising exercises for shoulder mass. But in truth, you gotta do them both. There's no one exercise. I would say, you know, a 50-50 ratio of doing side raise type exercises and the dumbbell press that we were just doing. Those, if I had to choose two exercises for shoulders, that would be it. Okay. Okay, let's, another question from YouTube. Lias 2001, sugar after a workout, ? You know, a lot has been made of post-workout recovery, beverages, drinks, protein shakes. You can get into that if you want. The pros obviously have to. The way I do it, I have 5 or 6 small, well-balanced meals a day. Because my workouts are probably, you know, 2.5 hours long with cardio, what happens, I'll eat 20 to 30 minutes before my workout. I'll work out, and then I'll eat right afterward. So I do not like the idea of adding useless calories in my diet just to get that post-workout insulin spike. So I don't like eating sugar for anything. I'm always fighting to keep my body fat low. The last thing I want to do is pump simple carbs in the form of sugar just to attempt to get some spike. Okay, let's go back to Facebook and answer a question on Facebook, and then I'll go back to YouTube. Okay. This is from Buddy Man Natural Way on Facebook. Hi, Scooby, do you eat carbohydrate like rice, whole grain bread? Yes, I eat a lot of carbohydrates. But the carbohydrates I eat are typically in the form of oats. I like rolled oats because there's a lot of fiber, far more than in wheat. The other place I get incredible amounts of carbohydrates from is beans. I eat a lot of beans. A significant amount of my protein comes from black beans and pinto beans. So yes, I eat a lot of complex carbohydrates, and they're very important. Okay, let's go back to YouTube for another question here. This is from B-Town's Most Wanted. How can I get a thick chest like you? I can't seem to build up my chest. I know you say it doesn't matter, but at one point I was benching 325 at 6 reps, and I still can't get it to grow like the rest of my body. Let's say, you know, there is a genetic max. You were benching 325. That's pretty respectable. It's very possible that you've reached your genetic max. Your chest can't grow forever, no matter how hard you try. I haven't gained any muscle mass or strength in 10 years. I reached my max. You know, it's possible you've reached yours. The one thing you might consider is checking your nutrition. If your nutrition is off, it's possible just by getting better nutrition you could start to make some gains again. But you know, you're pretty advanced. You may be at the limit. That's it. Let's see. Another question from YouTube. Okay, this is from Tim Spring. Do you like assisted pull-up machines, usually at gyms? First of all, most of my viewers work out at home, so they don't have access to an assisted pull-up machine nor a lat pull-down machine. There's a lot of things you can do at home that are the equivalent of that. For example, I have my video that's called How to Increase Your Pull-Ups. In that, I do something called walking the plank, where you step off a chair and lower yourself down when you can't do a pull-up. That's a great way to increase your lat strength. However, if you're in a gym, that's great. A lat pull-down machine is the equivalent of the assisted pull-up machine. They're both great. They both let you use a weight that you can control so that you can slowly increase the resistance every week and eventually build up to where you can do a normal pull-up. So yeah, it's a fine piece of machinery. Okay, I'm going to go back to Facebook and answer a question from Facebook. We've got another 6 minutes here. Marius asks, how much protein should my body get during the day? Let's say your weight is 70 kilograms, which is like 150 pounds. For a bodybuilder who is working out hard, I recommend 1 gram per pound. So for Marius, this would be about 150 grams a day. That's a pretty standard recommendation. Consuming more than that, it's doubtful it will help you, and when you get to a certain point, there is such a thing as too much protein. Now, could you cut back from 150 grams a day and still have good gains? Yeah, probably. The question is, you know, if you cut that in half and only had 75, how much would it hinder your muscular gains? You know, I don't know. Do you want to try it out? I'd stick with 150. There's a lot of discussion. Some people claim you can get all your protein in one sitting during the day. I disagree. Personally, I believe that when you spread it out over 4, 5, or 6 small, equal portions throughout the day, it's much more effective at helping you add muscle. Again, people disagree with this. Personally, I found that to be the case. Read the literature, do some experiments yourself, and decide what works for you. Okay, let's see. Here's an interesting question from Charlie on YouTube. He asks, am I bald? Well, I just clipped my hair, so I don't know if you can see. It's actually just clipped really short. It's I'm not actually bald. okay. Let's answer another question from YouTube here. Okay, this is from Pyrex4. Is creatine good for a teenager? Good question. For those of you that read my website, you know I am anti-supplement. It's not so much that I'm against the supplements, but the fact that there's no quality controls on the manufacturer of supplements. It routinely happens, you know, a couple times a year, somebody dies from toxic impurities in their supplements. It gets pulled from the market and kind of squashed in the news. Creatine is one of the few supplements that's been shown to actually help in bodybuilding. It's a very marginal gain, though. It's not like it makes you 50% stronger. You know, maybe it gives you a 5% edge. So if you don't mind risking having toxic impurities that destroy your liver, and you're an adult, I'd say, you know, go ahead and try it. As far as should a teen take it, I would say a definite no. The reason is, the first 2-3 years you're lifting, you have incredible gains. It's the newbie gains. And you do not need any assistance from supplements to get those gains. And it's unclear to me if you're wasting that money or not. But I would say, you know, if you're going to take supplements, which I don't recommend, wait 2 or 3 years of solid lifting when your gains start to stagnate before you consider taking them. Okay, Alaskar? Let's take another question from Facebook here. Okay, my Facebook is slow today. I'm not getting anything. Okay, question from Matt Hawk on Facebook. What do you think about upright rows? I don't like them. They're bad for the shoulders. I know, I love how it feels. Personally, I love doing them, but I don't because they're bad for the shoulders. So stick to shrugs. Much better exercise, in my opinion. Okay, let's go back to Facebook and answer a question there. This is an interesting question from Juicy Explosion. Can bones get stronger with muscles? Very interesting. There's a couple factors there. Weight-bearing exercise does make your bones stronger. That's been proven. Weightlifting makes your bones stronger. That's definitely proven. Now, something else that's interesting happens. Your ligaments also slowly get stronger when you're lifting. That is one of the big problems with people using steroids. They get injured because their muscles get stronger so fast that their bones and joints and ligaments haven't caught up. So they crash and burn, and then they're out of commission for years, and they get fat and sit on the sofa and drink beers and reminisce about when they used to be big and buff. Let's see, let's take another question from YouTube here. Okay, this is from Whatchavid112. What are your thoughts on deadlift, good or bad? Another good question. I don't do deadlifts. I have a history of back issues, and even the experts on powerlifting say that, you know, if you have any history of back problems, you should not do deadlifts. For people who have no history of back problems and have a good powerlifting coach who can show them how to do it properly when they're doing it and immediately correct the problems, then I'd say deadlifts are great. But, you know, if you're learning to do it yourself in a basement, no, don't do that. Skip them until you have a good powerlifting coach who can show you. Not a PE teacher, not a personal trainer.
a real powerlifting coach, because they're the ones that can keep you from killing yourself. Okay, let's go back to Facebook and answer another question there. Okay, I'm going to take one more question from Facebook and one from YouTube, then we're going to have to call it quits here. Okay, good question from Kevin Craner. Why don't you keep a log of the amount of weight and the number of reps that you use in each set? You know, this is a... I'm a hypocrite here. This is a do as I say, not as I do. But there's I have a good excuse. It's because I am in maintenance mode. I've been in maintenance mode for 10 years now. I reached my genetic max 10 years ago. My strength is stagnant. My muscle mass is stagnant. I remember exactly how many reps I did and the weight I did, because it hasn't changed in 10 years. For those of you who are constantly getting stronger because you have not reached your max, it's really important. Because, you know, you may not have done the side raise for 3 months. You need to be able to look back in your logbook and see, you know, the last time you did side raise, how much weight you did. So, good question, Kevin. You caught me at being a hypocrite. Yes, you should keep a logbook, and no, I don't. Let's take another question from YouTube here. And then we're going to have to call it quits. Workout summary, please. Vishak 1991. What I'll do, I'm going to make a page on my website about past live workouts and cover what I did in the workouts. I'll also change the video description to show what we actually did in the workout to make that easier. So again, thank you for joining me for this live broadcast shoulder workout. Remember again, tomorrow, same time, we're going to do an arm workout. Please join me for that. That is it for today. Auf Wiedersehen. Did in the workout to make that easier. So again, thank you for joining me for this live broadcast shoulder workout. Remember again, tomorrow, same time, we're going to do an arm workout. Please join me for that. That is it for today. Auf Wiedersehen.